Okay.
What about trying to increase your like natural EMFs? Like there's a this magnetico sleeping pad that gives like this polarized magnetic field, but where people try to sleep on and then they feel that, you know, they feel better EMF wise. Do you think that this would be a good strategy?
Okay, I didn't get the first part of your question. Sorry.
Like if you would amplify your natural Earth's magnetic field.
Okay.
Trying to combat the EMFs.
Okay. That's actually a very interesting question. There is some evidence that the EMFs that are close to the Schumann resonance, the 7.8 hertz, actually lowers the sensitivity of the VGCCs. So I've been saying they all work the same way, but there's one that there's some in that range that actually have an opposite effect. And that's so it's possible that you could get a favorable effect in that way. It might just lower the sensitivity of the voltage sensor to these other effects. You know, the problem is you really need to do a lot of quantitative studies on these things, and those have not been done. You know, I keep telling people, well, we know a lot about these things, and I think we do, but there are also a number of areas where we really would like to have a lot more information, and this is one of them.
So the question is, are our doctors able to identify these health effects from bad radiation?
Well, only if they know about them. That's, of course, the problem. Most of them don't know about any of these things. I mean, I guess the answer in principle is yes, but in practice is a different question. You know, what we really need, I think, is we need some measurements to be taken before and after 5G is turned on. In order to know that, we need to know when the 5G is turned on. We need to have people who are willing to be tested. I mean, there are a number of these things that can be tested by standard clinical tests. You know, you can measure oxidative stress responses, for instance. You can measure nitric oxide. So there are ways of doing these things with standard clinical tests. But, you know, if nobody's collecting the data, then it doesn't help us any. You know, I've been trying to encourage public organizations that seem to be perfectly willing to allow us to be exposed to actually do some measurements to find out what's going on in our bodies. But so far, I haven't been able to find anybody that I can persuade to do that.
If you have any information on how much awareness is there in the United States about what's really going on with radiation and the effects of EMFs through media?
Almost none. It's starting to change now, but so I guess I have some hopes that maybe people will become more aware. But I mean, you know, I mean, there was an article that was published in the New York Times by a Pulitzer Prize-winning reporter, that when you look at that article, it was just straight industry propaganda. That was done about, four weeks ago, I think, something like that. I mean, you know, the media are just, it's just extraordinary what's going on. And it doesn't, you know, we are seeing some improvements, but, you know, we're also seeing some things that are going backwards, if anything. I do have some hope that things are moving in the right direction, but at this point it's so slow that it may not make any difference. Let me just say something more about the situation in the U.S. You know, we take great pride in our science in the U.S. We have far more Nobel laureates than any other country. And we think, oh, we're the top dogs in science. But in this area, we're nowhere. And the reason we're nowhere is because all the public funding got cut off between 1986 and 1999. And since then, there's been almost nothing done in the U.S. other than what the industry is funding. The consequences of that is that we've had somewhere around 350,000 cell phone towers put up, many of them with, you know, strong government support, and there has not been one study done in the U.S. on the health effects of living near cell phone towers. There have been studies, there have been 17 studies that have been published on this. They've all been done elsewhere. We have Wi-Fi all over the place. There have been 23 studies published on genuine Wi-Fi radiation. Not a single one of them has been done in the U.S. And it's almost as bad with the cell phones, except that we had the NTP study. I hate to say this, but by this criterion, and there are other criteria that you might want to use, but by this criterion, the U.S. science is the most corrupted science in the world. You know, I say this with incredible personal regret. You know, and there were a lot of people in the U.S. who had funding back when there was funding, and then the funding got off, and a number of these people are now testifying for the industry on these things. So, anyway, that's the world we live in.